In this video, we will be studying about the inward-looking trade strategy, which is also known as the import substitution strategy. After independence, see what our government focused on. The government focused on that the import, India should reduce its import and it should produce the goods in India itself so that they do not have to be dependent on the rest of the world for their needs. So this was the outlook of the Indian government at the time after the independence, right? So they need a strategy, they formed a strategy that we have a strategy, we will do the export promotion and import substitution. These were the two main principles of the inward looking trade strategy. Which means export promotion, it is a strategy to earn for foreign exchange by promoting domestic exports and making domestic industry competitive in the international market. That we will establish the domestic industry and whatever the finished goods we use to import from rest of the world, we will itself produce in India, and we as a domestic industry will export the goods to the rest of the world. Now we will be the exporter of the finished goods, not the importer of the finished goods. This was the first principle of the inward looking trade strategy. Now what is import substitution? It is a strategy to save foreign exchange by encouraging domestic production of such goods which the country has been importing from rest of the world. So domestic industries offered protection from foreign competition through import restriction and import duties. That foreign product should not come in India. So Indian government has imposed heavy import duties and import restrictions so that the domestic industry should not get the competition from the foreign industries. So these were the main two principles of this strategy: export promotion and import substitution. So the good impacts of these strategies were: number one, high rate of industrial growth with structural transformation. See, with this strategy, there was a growth of the Indian industry. We all have studied this. the Indian industry, the domestic industry, have grown up substantially. Now, there was the growth in the industry with a structural transformation, which means the GDP, the industrial sector, had increased its percentage share in GDP corresponding to the fall in the percentage share of the agriculture sector. The GDP sector, which is constitute of the primary sector, secondary sector and tertiary sector. The secondary sector, which is the industrial sector, has increased its percentage in the GDP. Now, the economic growth along with the structural transformation is also known as the economic development. Economic growth along with structural transformation is called economic development. Now we have grown ourselves with modernization, equity and gender opportunities of employment. These were the good impacts of this strategy. Second is diversification of industrial growth. See, there was not only one industry, whereas many industries, coal industry, electricity industry, steel industry, iron industry, like there were diversification of industrial growth. The industries were diversified from textile and jute industry to electronic industry, from electronic industry to steel industry. So everything, there was a diversification of industrial growth is because we wanted to grow everything, we wanted to produce everything in Indian boundaries. Opportunities of investment. See, these small scale industries were opened up with the new opportunities of investment for those who do not have the much capital. At that time of independence, I've told in the previous video that small scale industries required, at that time it used to require only 5 lakh rupees to start up your small scale industry. So people, those who do not have much capital with themselves to invest, they could open up the small scale industry within 5 lakh rupees. So this gives an opportunity of investment to those people who do not have much capital with themselves. Fourth was use of latent resources. India started using its potential resources in order to manufacture its goods in the domestic boundaries itself. So we started making use of the resources. So these were the good impacts of this strategy. The bad impact of this strategy one, growth of inefficient public monopolies. See, before 1990, the telecommunication was only in the hand of the government. So we also know what was the condition of the BSNL at that time. We cannot able to connect. People have to wait for years and years to have the phone connection to themselves. So how the public enterprises work, how these government companies work, we all know. So the growth was inefficient of the public monopolies. There was a monopoly, there was only one seller and there were large number of buyers. So there was a public monopoly which came into existence and it has a bad effect on the Indian economy. Lack of competition implied lack of modernization. See, we know that Nokia, they bought up a small phone. After that, Samsung came up with the smartphones. After that, the Samsung got a high competition from the other brands such as Oppo, MI phones and Vivo phones, right? So, until and unless there is no competition, there will be no modernization. Because if there was no Samsung, Nokia would have continued with their same keypad phones, right? So, whereas Samsung came up with the new technology in India. So with this, what Nokia did, Nokia also shifted to the new technology. So if there is no competition, there will be no modernization. Third, indiscriminate. Spread of public sector enterprises. See, the public sector used to do anything and everything to public sector undertakings. So public sector undertakings, there was less opportunity of investment. So the public sector undertaking became inefficient. They started suffering losses. So indiscriminate spread of public sector enterprises in producing such goods as bread and shoes, which could easily be left to the private sector. Right? You can you could have at that point. Now it is with the private sector, but at that time you could have left these goods in the hand of private sectors. What was the need to keep it in the hand of public sector enterprises? So there was less growth. Fourth is the economically unviable state enterprises. A political compulsion. Now, the politics. The politics had a very great hold on the state enterprise or the public enterprises. So, due to this politic, these enterprises started becoming corrupted, inefficient. They were suffering losses because people were not actually the workers who were working, who were the employees of these public enterprises, were corrupted. They were not working properly in order to earn the profit. So significantly, they started suffering the continuous losses. So these were the bad impact of this strategy. I hope you like our video. Please download our Scholars Learning app and enjoy the learning experience with us.